Not before destroy all humans. Going to continue with the storyline. And hopefully I have enough brains to get through some of the missions. I really don't like it to where I yes, need indeed. DNA to get through. Alien storm, I brainstem.
Why does that title remind me of something else?
I don't know.
Oh, it reminds me of Zombies Ate My Neighbor. I forgot what that game was about, but that was a long time ago.
I want you to collect any brain stems that may have survived the signal broadcast still intact. While you're collecting the overloaded brain stems, take a moment and extract 300 DNA from living humans. Would you?
Living humans?
Wow. Collectathon!
These mines fire an electromagnetic pulse that disables your weapons and jetpack. Avoid the EMP mines if you can.
He's talking about that thing over there.
Yeah. I suppose the humans have become a little bit smarter, haven't they?
Yeah. But not all that smart, even though they can EMP my gear. They can't disable my PK.
Welcome to planet Earth.
Huh?
You haven't got the guts.
Did he just say welcome to planet Earth?
Yep.
What accent was that, I wonder?
I don't know. No overloaded brain stem from that. That was a miss.
Never wanted them anyway.
Run, humans, run. Your doom has arrived.
Possible communist activities have been detected. Patrols are on the lookout for any possible communist activities.
Communist activity? Are these people that stupid?
Probably.
You're being attacked by an alien and you're saying it's communist? Come on now. The Russians ain't that evil.
Gosh, you're not losing focus. Maybe I should activate that cheat again.
Yeah, you could, or you could risk making everybody mute again, like that one time.
Let's not make everyone unmute like Link.
Link.
Oh, you realize
something? Okay. Go ahead. I'll say after you.
You realize how this anal probe works, right?
Yeah, I just make them grab their butts, start running, and then their heads explode.
You just collected an overloaded brain stem. Only 11 more to go. Well, I know it sounds like a lot, but I think it's quite an achievable goal.
Achievable goal?
Okay.
Box, this ain't Xbox.
Perhaps this game was on the had a port on the Xbox, possibly.
Excellent.
No?
Probably.
I believe that's all the fresh brain stems I'll be needing at the moment. Ice hot.
Well, what exactly causes them to start grabbing their butt and running off?
Well, I don't know, the weapon is aimed towards their butts, so... I don't know. This thing probably shoots a drill in their butt cheeks, which drills up to their head and makes their heads explode, thus releasing the brain.
Yeah, that actually sounds very painful. Now, the thing I wanted to question is, why does Link have a voice, but he doesn't speak?
I don't know. Oh, here's...
I mean, you hear...
Oh.
Go ahead.
Because, like, okay, I've seen many games where Link was in, even Soul Calibur and a few others. You hear him screaming in battle, doing his war cry, whatever. But again, when it comes to interacting with other characters, he doesn't speak.
I really don't get that, but wait. They did something for, what was that last Legend of Zelda game on the Wii? I don't remember the name, but he could have choices in that game, but it really didn't affect the ending and whatnot. And he didn't even voice them.
I think I remember what you're talking about. Yeah, I think I remember that game. What was it called?
Don't remember the name, but it did have Link riding a bird.
Maybe somebody will remind us in the comments.
Yeah, hopefully. Hey, oh, and Majestic Agents are not fooled by the disguise, and they can deactivate it. As you can see, when my disguise is glowing red.
Yeah.
You're hurting my feelings. Out of range.
Wonder if I ought to go hit somebody with my nightstick. Could be fun.
He sounds Scottish.
Probably.
Did he just say pathetic Furon?
Yep.
How does he know about the Furon? Oh wait, this is one of those men in black. Never mind.
Yeah, and you remember that first cutscene, right? In the game?
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, Crypto.
There's a Furon around here. I can smell it. Oh, man. You have the right to get your arse kicked.
I have the right to get my arse kicked?
Boy,
okay.
My gosh. The dialogue in this game is just hilarious. So far, I'm enjoying this.
Grab the brain. There you go.
I like how you're still able to jump as if you were on the moon, but you're on Earth. Perhaps I should be questioning this guy's body mass, probably.
Yeah.
Probably what I should be questioning.
Disturbances on the increase. Extra patrols have been sent to investigate.
Now the army's coming in.
Oh my gosh.
This ain't like WW2.
Party's over, Space Rat.
Space Rat? I'm sorry, but does a gray alien look any bit like a space rat?
I don't know. 6 out of 12. I think we're like halfway in.
Police! Come on out of there!
You have the right to remain in ash.
We're getting our puns on. What?
The authorities are already up!
And there's a thing in the swimming pool.
Yeah, DNA probe. I can get it. Oh, crap. Well, until I can deal with these.
Hey, I saw your pal laid out.
These guys say some pretty messed up things when they interact with you.
You're terminated.
What? You're terminated? I hope that wasn't a Terminator reference. We've already had a Terminator reference in Doom.
Nightstick, check. Taking bribes from local gangster, check. Sense of moral superiority over fellow citizens, check. Time to arrest me some peeps.
Wow.
Come on, Crypto, you can reach the top of that building. There you go.
And this is why humanity is doomed. Because of police officers like that.
Okay, maybe if I stay up here, the heat will chill.
Oh yeah, you want to know something crazy?
Yep.
So not too long ago, there was a video uploaded to YouTube, right? And they were showing some UFOs in China. And here's the thing, there was a crazy little thing going on over there. For some reason, some of the UFOs appear to be much larger crafts than the usual, right? And then there's this weird cylinder-looking thing flying around. It looked very weird. And I was questioning it, like, could that thing be man-made? It's like, it doesn't look like it could. It was like just a weird flying cylinder just flying through China. Oh man, it was just ridiculously big. Like, you could measure it with a couple of skyscrapers.
God, if aliens ever do invade, then I don't know what to do. I don't know whether to get friendly or probably stay it clear. Because I like to keep my brain intact, thank you.
Eh, no worries. I think we could handle an alien invasion.
Yeah.
I think.
Leave that to Area 51.
Oh yeah.
Nice.
Like, we have a lot of good technology going into the military now, so we're pretty good.
Yeah. There is still more to our tale, and I shall not let it end.
Indeed.
What's going on there? Can't we all just get along?
Not for Crypto.
Whatever. I'm on a Space, join us out. I'm a
your numbers up, Space Ray.
And then I heard this funny little story, or actually it was kind of sad. There was this dude who said that he and his buddies, they actually fought some aliens in the mountains. He actually killed two of them, right? And he was talking about how they had contact with aliens before, right? And they actually met a friendly alien or something. But not too long after he was talking about that, he got killed somehow. They suspected he was probably murdered, possibly by a choking weapon. Yeah, who knows.
Hmm.
Now, I'm not exactly the type of person to believe in aliens exactly. Granted, a lot of this stuff does seem very crazy. You know, a lot of the funny stories I hear about these UFOs.
One thing to note, Crypto can't swim.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, that's why I've been avoiding water.
Well, I mean, this is early PlayStation 2, so there weren't many moments where you can just hop in the water and expect to swim, right? There were just very few games that did it at the time. I could name a few games that had swimming mechanics, but there weren't too many. I remember one of the first games that I played with swimming mechanics, believe it or not, was a PlayStation 1 game. It was called Stuart Little 2. You ever seen those movies?
Yeah, I've seen like both of them.
Yeah, bet you weren't expecting them to have a PlayStation 1 game as adaptations. Quantum mechanics in grad school.
Stunted sniper strikes again. 16 die as this deformed lurkin stalks Clancy Street Estate.
They're doing their best to hide the truth.
Well,
I'm sorry, but if an alien
those brain stems should be more than sufficient for my research and testing purposes. Oh, science!
I'm sorry, but if an alien trashed an entire neighborhood all by himself, I don't think you can easily hide that. As a matter of fact, I'm surprised none of these people are taking pictures. Extra patrols have been sent to check out the situation. I know this is early suburban, you know, but hey, somebody's gotta be carrying around a camera or something. I hear you mashing.
Yeah, this is helpful. You try to stay in the air. Second game, they fixed it to where you won't have to tap it. I don't want to get fall damage.
Oh, you can get fall damage here?
Yep.
That I didn't know.
No, come on! Get back! Oh, what is this? The Santa Pre? How about I get this first? Come on.
Welcome to Earth, brother.
I'm not going to ask you again. Come back here.
There we go.
Okay, that was very confusing. Was that Pox talking or was that somebody else?
Nope, that was someone else.
Okay.
Probably do that in a separate video. Let's go ahead and get back and go on to the main story.
Just what you need, a bigger gun. Well, you step right, saucer upgrades.
Okay. Hey, I am now all informed that as whenever you have a new upgrade to purchase, it will tell you in a mothership.
That's good to know.
Now on to the next mission, this island, Suburbia.
Suburbian Island? We go once more to destroy all humans.
Crypto?
Yes, Master?
You're going to investigate the activities of the human scientists. I want to establish their connection with the Majestic.
All American and a fast food sensation. Government scientists helping to defend against communism through better cuisine?
Huh? Okay, Einstein, I don't know how you're gonna do that, but you can try.
Retrieve information from the scientists. How can you protect people from aliens with food?
Maybe the aliens are allergic to the food. That's all you need. Just grab a beef patty and start throwing them at the green alien. I'm sorry, gray alien.
Oh well, time to light the grill.
Okay, this is pretty funny. I like that the cars over here, they can actually flip over. When did this game come out originally?
Hostile xenophobes by adding chemicals to restaurant food.
Okay, I don't know. Probably somewhere in the mid-2000s. What the? Why are these people angry?
Hey, Yuri! We don't want your kind around here.
Because I remember I was playing a lot of PS2 games from around the 2000s, and a lot of them didn't have a lot of the physics that most PS2 games had, like swimming or the cars flipping over, right? Like how you're able to do them here. Now, of course, there were a few exceptions.
Ever since I was a small boy in Stuttgart, I dreamed of drugging the food supply of an entire population. Now, it's my job. God, I love America.
America, the country of opportunity.
Country of opportunity. Okay.
Come on, commie. Assault my virtue. I dare you.
Assault my virtue?
This...
Traitor!
I've got one! Over here! Somebody get me a shotgun!
What?
Don't do that! I know I'm not supposed to eat from the diner, or I'll turn into a mindless paranoid drone, but that rhubarb pie is calling my name. Heinrich! Liebchen! Heinrich!
What's wrong with
these people? The psychotropic compounds in that scheißen turned our lab rats into a pack of paranoid junkies.
I'm trying to
clearly
guess.
The scientists are responsible for carrying out Majestic's population control schemes. Normally, I'd ask you to destroy the scientists, but we have a bigger problem. Majestic are using the food outlets to distribute their population control drugs. And it seems to be working. If every human in this country turns paranoid and hostile, it will make life for us very difficult. You may want to use the salsa for this.
Oh, I guess we're gonna destroy the diner.
Yep.
screw fast food anyways. I didn't like it to begin with.
Let's go forth and rain down justice with our wicked ride.
Yes, indeed. I still wonder what accents those scientists have, or at least the voice actor of those scientists, because they all seem to be sharing the same voice actor.
Scottish?
Possibly. I don't know, the police officer had a more Scottish accent. These guys are trying to sound either more German or Russian or Italian. I don't know. I can't really tell the difference. I mean, I'm a Romanian, quite out loud. I don't get to speak to many people from other with different accents.
Suspicious activity.
Burn, burn, burst the ground!
Oh my gosh.
I know what you're thinking. Blame Hyenard.
Yeah. That's never gonna get old. All you need to do to annoy somebody is just have a recording of Blame Hyenard from Mega Man 8-7. And that's it. It's over. Any war that you were supposed to engage on, you've already won.
They just took the diner, too. We gotta set up a line and hold them here.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm not sitting around here waiting to get abducted.
Keep your panties on, Mary. I just got a word over the radio. There's an army convoy right outside this town. With tanks.
Thank God.
Thank Majestic. Silhouette got the army to do something right for once. Take some cars and go get them.
Try and stop me.
Tanks against a saucer? I'd like to see you try.
The only way a tank's taking down this saucer is if they've improved the tanks to have futuristic military equipment that is specially made to take down alien saucers, which I believe these humans haven't realized yet.
Oh, great! Majestic had made contact with the army group!
Oh, and that's the health item I mentioned in a past video.
Oh yeah, that's how you repair your saucer, yes?
Yep. Oh.
Alright, so I guess they... Huh?
I really don't like how my health meter is dark, because I can't really see it.
I can kind of see it.
I can kind of tell. Ah, rocket! Leave me alone!
Looks like they're actually trying compared to the first level. How does he book like that in those shoes?
I don't know. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to land because there are too many Sam sites.
You know what's funny is like you're landing your saucer all the way here, yet nobody's going to question it or call the authorities about it.
Maybe Majestic are like Eggman and from Sonic Unleashed. That was all part of the plan, part of the big picture. Where's the fun of having my plan succeed without any challenge?
Now I remember I played a PlayStation 2 Transformers game. It was like after it was like made as a promotion to the first Transformers film by Michael Bay, right? And yeah, you kind of know my opinion about the Michael Bay movies already, or well, I probably should talk about it again. But basically the movies I didn't like. The game, however, the first game, I gotta say, it wasn't horrible. It was kind of fun. Granted, it has a lot of problems that really ruined the experience for me. But one thing that I liked about that game is you can grab... okay, you know how like there was a gas station with a donut over it, right? Here in this game?
Yeah.
In that game, you can just jump over that and grab the donut or hot dog or burger or whatever it was in that game and then just throw it at things. I gotta say, that was pretty funny.
Wow.
That was one of the fun things about that. I wish a feature like that would come back, you know, in most games where you can just grab stuff from the environment and just throw them around. But there are not too many games that do that, unfortunately. I would assume that the new Transformers Devastation by Platinum, I would assume that that game is pretty good and maybe I can do stuff like that again.
End of the line, Em.
Get ready for probing!
Oh, this is the guy that you needed to hypnotize?
Yeah. So far, we're in the clear, and since he's hypnotized, he won't deactivate my disguise.
What am I thinking? I could tell you, but then I'd have to kill you.
Show yourself. I'm a police officer.
Oh, wow.
Whoa!
No,
get up. Get up.
Okay. For a second there, I thought he was either dead, and when I saw him getting up, I'm like... Okay, maybe you'll have to hypnotize him again.
No, because if he died, that would have been a mission failed.
Look at
I was
these
like,
people.
No, I missed.
Pathetic. Without us, they'd like be toast. I like Huffman, but I'll kill him in a second if I get the order.
Wow. Such loyalty to your stalwart partners. To a fellow stalwart hero.
Now if they send me into Cuba, bam, no more problem. That's all I'm saying.
Wow.
Why does Silhouette give me these jobs? I wonder if it's because I hit on her at the Majestic Christmas party. Wait. No one's even supposed to know Silhouette's a chick. Scratch that thought.
Too late. We
nope.
Now know what Silhouette is.
Yep. We now know she is a chick.
Which means she's probably easier to capture and hypnotize. I think we know why we're making that assumption.
Go to hell, Klaatu. You think I'm scared of a 3-foot space hamster?
I think you should be. Now, we can do this easy, or we can do it hard. Your choice. What do you know about a down Furon scout ship?
A what?
Sorry, let me put it in baby talk. A flying saucer crashed somewhere, or captured.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course not. What do you know about Majestic?
I know we're gonna kick your little green ass all the way back to Mars.
I'm not! These weapons, where are you making them? How many agents does Majestic have? How many other towns are you in?
son of a...
Don't get mad. Get sadistic. I think this calls for the jumbo probe.
Oh, I think that should hurt.
I wouldn't know.
Hurts, don't it, monkey boy? You want it to stop, don't you? Then give daddy what he needs.
Mind control experiment. Rockwell movies. Furon DNA. Area 42.
Prepare to return to the mothership, Crypto. We're going back to Rockwell for the last time.
In a second. Hold still, monkey boy. Let me just.
What?
The head.
Oh boy. So I'm guessing we ate his brain, right?
Mm-hmm. Government official vanishes. Last seen wearing black suit and tie and hat. Reward if found.
Oh yeah, they forgot to include that he's kind of lost his hat, especially in that cutscene.
Yep.
Back to the mothership.
Okay. Hey, I think we've done like three missions, right?
Three. I thought we did two. I think.
Two. Oh, okay. Let's do another one. Teenage zombies from outer space.
Okay. We descend one more onto the earth to punish the pathetic humans for their stupidity.
I'm sick and tired of this two-bit town. Nothing ever happens.
No dancing, no rock and roll. Why, if it weren't for that juke joint down by the river, I'd never get my rocks off.
You said a mouthful, Cupcake. There's a whole wide world out there, and we're missing it.
But where can we go, Billy? This town's a one-way ticket for wild hearts like you and me.
It's tearing me apart!
What you need is a new direction.
Exactly.
A real purpose in life.
Freaking A!
Ever thought about homeland protection?
Home what?
Wise up, Romeo. There's a half a billion Reds who'd love nothing better than to rip that varsity sweater right off your back.
No kidding.
Take this little pamphlet. It'll tell you everything you need to know about protecting your little corner of the country from communist invasion.
Thanks a million, Daddy-O!
Freaking A.
Wow. There goes a real America.
A real American dreamboat? Meow.
We're over here just playing whatever this is. No. I'm good.
That's the last of them. Must have papered every JD in the stinking burg.
And our little film strip?
Spooled up and ready to go. The pimply projectionist is none the wiser. Won't those kids be surprised when Abbott and Costello turn into Jimmy and Johnny Commie Killer in Reel 6?
Good work, Agent, and not a moment too soon. We need to be in Santa Modesta yesterday. Don't break for yellow. Read me?
Loud and clear.
Wonder who this guy is.
That silhouette.
Sounded like Secret Agent Man was taking orders from the one in
Giles. Oh, that silhouette.
Want me to blow him up?
Thank you, Crypto, but I have a better idea. See the plaza over there by the big screen? The humans drive their carbon combustion transports in, and thence view projected images for the purpose of entertainment.
Makes perfect sense.
I suggest we beat Majestic at their own devious little game.
We make our yes. movie.
Got my bus ticket. Hollywood, here I come. Save me a seat at Schwab's.
Yeah, lady, I don't think you're going to be able to pay a visit to Hollywood.
Mm-mm.
And besides, Hollywood's bad enough as it is. We don't need you to make things worse.
Mm-hmm. Blue Moon Drive-In Cinema.
Martians from Mars.
People turning south.
Martha,
the freeway.
Give me the
we're
shotgun.
When they
I got
this
is
the end line. Of the road.
Huh?
They said this is
filthy
the end of the road.
Earth, human. What weapon is that that you're wielding?
Probably a hand-wielded ray gun. What the? Why is this dude hiding here?
He is a coward.
Oh, come on.
The truth is right. This is about
wow, it takes about 3 hits from this. Oh! Now this dude is bringing in a heavy artillery!
You little freak!
Huh.
Stop it! Right now!
He doesn't seem to be able to wield it, however.
Yes, he is.
Excellent! I've prepared a special film that I'm sure the audience will love. Be a good boy and pick it up.
I'm on it.
Reason why I said he doesn't appear to wield it is because he's a terrible shot.
I'm trying to show you the weapon that he was wielding. Come on, and you know what? Fine. If you don't want to show me the weapon, then I don't like you.
Eh, it doesn't matter.
What is going on here?
Oh, it's one of these kind of cinemas. Okay.
Oh. I don't like it. Change the movie.
Yeah, that looks very boring. Some boring military film. Those are never fun. Let's change it to something more exciting.
Yeah. Oh, there's a probe over there. Oh, come on. You know what? My anal probe won't work. I'll just have to do this the old-fashioned way.
Electrocute him to death.
Well, near death, and then try to extract.
Don't ask, don't tell. Works for me. Brain.
Okay. Looks like that ain't gonna work. Let's just grab this thing. Play the Furon film. Much better.
Yeah, we don't need to watch a lot of stupid, boring military movies. We're patriotic enough.
Mm-hmm. Now, sit back and enjoy the following educational presentation from the Furon Empire.
What?
Oh, I think we need to get a little bit closer.
The humans are trying to stop the movie! Kill the bastards! Have they no respect for that?
Indeed, they don't have any respect for good art.
Mm-hmm. Hands out the film! Go away! I don't like you!
You ever?
Wonder why the music stopped.
I don't know. Probably it just stopped for the film.
Did it do this on the PS2 version as well?
Yeah.
Hold it. Nobody. Majestic is going to come after you. He always will.
Whoops.
As soon as I get down, you are one dead alien.
That is if you can survive. Which you didn't. Oh!
Lesson number one, how to kill a Fuhrer.
Film's almost done. There we go. Furon hits six. Meet the Furons. Has something for everyone.
So that's all we did, basically. Just play a movie in front of them, right?
Yep.